Hello everyone. So today we are going to learn some easy mysterious creatures by drawing number 1 to 5. So here I'm creating a creature by using number 1. So it looks somewhat like a snail and the face looks somewhat like a tortoise. But I wanted to make it mysterious, so I added few more patterns on its back and a few patterns on his skin. I'm drawing here by using a black sketch pen. You may try drawing this first with pencil and then you can add this with black sketch pen. You can also try drawing some different patterns. You can get creative. Have your own ideas. Now to color this, we don't need some fancy colors. I'm using simple 24 shades of camel oil pastels. You may use whatever is available with you. So here you can see it's light green and light orange color. I'm using it to blend it with each other and create a beautiful color scheme. Now always remember that if you want your work to look really attractive, maintain a good contrast in your coloring. So you can color the body of the dinosaur light, then make the pattern in darker shade, as I have done it here by using violet and brown. And keep the foreground really little random by using dark brown color. And you must be wondering, what is it that I'm using here to bring some effect. So it's, a earbud or a Q-tip. And of course, find pride to sign your picture. Now, this is number 2. Initially, it looked like swan. If you look at the legs, they look like elephant's legs. And if you look at the tail, it looks like Brontosaurus tail. So this animal is, a mixture or inspiration from all these animals. There's a lot of inspiration that you can find in nature. So observe nature keenly and create new and innovative drawings. So here I wanted to give a feel of summer. So I'm using, one of the most unused colors of your oil pastel set, that is ochre yellow color. I'm sure hardly children use it. So here, I was inspired by camel. And I decided to give the, skin color as camel skin color over here. And to color the stones, I am using brown and, a little bit of sap green. So it gives a nice shade, here. And for sky, I am showing bright, sunshine. And using a little dash of blue in the cloud, it makes your composition very interesting. Also, don't draw simple lines for sun, Use your Q-tip or earbud and blend it. It gives a nice artistic feel to your picture. And as I told you earlier, always take pride in signing your artwork. So what is hidden in number 3? By the time number 3 creature is forming, I would like to tell you that how have I got, inspired to make these drawings. So my daughter and her friend, Ichi, Chatura is my daughter, and her friend Ichi, or his name is like Yuvan Vadhavan, he's our neighbor. So these guys sit together and, you know, throughout the day they would keep drawing dinosaurs, various kinds of dinosaurs, and their, you know, this fascination for these animals inspired me to create something different and new. And thus I got these ideas. So like by now you must have recognized that it's a mouse, which, you know, we see all around us all the time. And you know, how does a mouse look mysterious? So, you know, I got inspired by Tyrannosaurus Rex, and that's why I use those spikes on its back and on its tail, you know, to make it a little mysterious. And here in the background I'm creating a small den, you know, and I'm showing two eyes like inside. Basically all of us here, like, you know, in India and all over the world, this April 2020, you know, we are facing this COVID-19 pandemic, and we are made to sit at home for good, for greater good. So like, we don't step out and we don't spread the virus. It's good for humanity. So this mouse is basically stepping out to get some daily grocery and warning his family members to be inside the house. So he's turning back and making sure that his family members are there at home. Nobody is coming behind him. That was a little story, you know, which came to my mind. Now some of you may be wondering, oh really, he's going out to get grocery, then why is he not wearing the mask? So guys, you can make a mask. You can make whichever kind of mask you want to make for this mouse. And thus you can color his day in, and then color the foreground with little brownish and grayish colors, and with Q-tip you can mix it. So that was number 3. Okay, number 4 is really interesting, and it was challenging for me. So I was really wondering, okay, like, which interesting mysterious creature can I make with number 4? And slowly when I was thinking and trying out my sketches, I got this idea, like, there is a creature, you know, I mean, it's called Komodo dragon. So the very name of this creature, you know, is like very inspiring. So that's why, like, you know, I created this particular creature, which is kind of a mixture of a lizard and a dragon and a frog. So here you can see, you know, all these different characteristics of these animals, body characteristics of this animal I have used here and created this animal. And I thought, you know, I'll show something more interesting around. So these are those tiny flies or bees, which are generally the food of this kind of creature. And for color, I decided to go with more vibrant colors. So here you can see I've used orange and yellow. And so like here you'll find I'm using violet color. Be very careful when you use this violet color, because this oil pastels, all oil pastels have a tendency to lose little particles, you know, on your paper. They keep falling all the time. So if you have a habit of touching your hand to your paper while coloring, you might, you know, spoil your paper. So make sure that there are no tiny particles of this color lying around while you're coloring. Believe me, I had great fun doing this work, you know. So you'll also enjoy doing it. I also have an idea for all of you. So below in comment box, please suggest what should I name, you know, to these characters, these mysterious creatures. So if you have some wonderful ideas, you can write number one and the name of the mysterious animal. So sooner my new videos are coming within next few days. I will definitely mention your name and the names that you suggested for the, you know, these mysterious creatures. So number five. And also if you've enjoyed, you know, making this, seeing this video and making these drawings, do share them with your friends and family. So like they can also have fun. And for art, there is no age limit. Whether you are 6 or 60, it doesn't matter. You can try doing these animals. Believe me, I had great satisfaction creating these pictures. It is so relaxing and so therapeutic. So try out these. Now you must be wondering, how come this picture is not seen fully? So I thought of going a little mysterious with you and left a little part, you know, which is not seen. And I wanted to see like whether you could think how would that look. And towards the end of this video, you will definitely be able to see this creature completely. So there you can understand that what you thought, what you created in your mind or on your paper, did it match with what I thought or what my creation was? However, it really doesn't matter so far as you happy creating it. So I'm not going to tell you yet which animals have inspired me to make these, this particular creature. Okay, here I have also experimented and tried using multiple mediums. So I have used here sketch pens for coloring the spots because I felt it will be easier to color the spots with a sketch pen. Also, it breaks the monotony, you know, of using same colors and medium over and over again. So this hair-like structure can be created very beautifully by using, you know, the sketch pens. Because this felt pens or sketch pens have very finer tip, which allows you to, you know, get fine and clean lines and edges. So using sketch pen, I am coloring this, the orange and the brown color I have used. Also make sure when you use sketch pen, don't put too much pressure over your sketch pen. Otherwise your sketch pen and the paper, both will get spoiled. And I have used very simple sketch pens here. These are 12 shades of camel oil pastel which I have used. So all these things are available at your home currently, you know. So you can try these. I think by now you must have recognized the animals, you know, the inspiration behind this particular creation. So yes, one of them is giraffe, of course. And there the mystery reveals, and you can see the legs part. So it was again the Tyrannosaurus Rex which inspired me. So I tried to combine the, you know, body structure and the skin pattern of these two animals and created this particular creature. I enjoyed making this. Believe me, it's great fun. Oh, look at that Tyrannosaurus. So you can see the shaking of it, you know, there. So do, you know, make these pictures and stay tuned for our next video, which is going to be number 6 to 10. And don't forget to hit that bell icon and do like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.